Howdy friends, welcome back to Strength and Discipline. This is Madoc, and it is day 13 of our 100 kettlebell swings a day for 100 days challenge. I'm going to swing that 20 kilogram kettlebell right there 100 times. Let's go ahead and get to it.
All right, 100 kettlebell swings with a 20 kilogram kettlebell. I'm gonna break it into four sets of 25. Here we go. That was either between 100 or 105. Did a couple of extra to make sure.
And I'm back. All right, friends, that was 100 kettlebell swings with that 20 kilogram kettlebell. Long-term goal is that 48 kilogram gold kettlebell right there off my shoulder. I want to talk about grip strength today, right? So we've got this little grip dynamometer thing. It's a relatively inexpensive one I found off of Amazon a few years ago. If I had the money and the need for it, I would get one of those awesome machined steel digital readout spring-loaded grip dynos that you see in PT's offices, right? We test people's grip in here on a fairly regular basis, not so much in the class, but in private sessions with people. Grip strength, besides being an indicator of, you know, just how strong your grip is also a fairly good indicator of your sort of neurologic state. So if you're doing a lot of heavy lifting, like really heavy lifting, super heavy power lifting, or regular weightlifting, Olympic style lifts on a regular basis, your grip is a good indicator of your overall fatigue, right? So I use HRV monitoring to determine my overall aerobic fatigue, as well as like the sway between my sympathetic and my parasympathetic nervous state. But if you're doing a lot of strength work, you can show up to a training session with a fairly high HRV readout and still be overly fatigued in a sort of a neurologic state, right? You can have used up effectively your go juice, for lack of a better term. I'm sure that there's scientific words that I could be using, but a good way of thinking about it is that your nerves have to fire your muscles, and if your nerves are really fatigued and they're have given up all of the various electrolytes and neurotransmitters that they need in order to get the muscles firing in a previous work session, if you're not completely neurologically recovered, you're not going to have necessarily a good work session. And we want to train more to success and less to failure on a regular basis. So it might do you some good to get an inexpensive grip tester, right? This thing was only about $20 off of Amazon. It might be more expensive now. I don't know how accurate it is as far as the actual kilograms per hand that I'm force that I'm generating per hand, but it is consistent. And consistency with your measurements when you're doing any sort of recovery measurement is important, right? So if your measurements are off and you see like a 10% variance and the machinery or however you're testing is reliable, that's a pretty good indicator of neural fatigue and maybe backing it off from the heavy duty strength work. So the kettlebell swing stuff that we're doing is starting to fatigue my grip strength a little bit, which means that I'm accumulating quite a bit of neurologic fatigue. Now, I don't anticipate that I'm going to throw myself into an overtraining state or anything along those lines doing 100 kettlebell swings a day. But cumulatively, I am definitely going to be challenging myself. So when you're doing long-term training, one of the things that you want to do is have some sort of metric that you're training against, right? Grip strength, right? Day one, I should have said, hey, get a grip dyno, test out your grip, or grab a Captain of Crush or something, right? How much force can you generate with your grip, closed grip strength? And then as you start training more, keep track of that once a week, once every other week, something along those lines if you're not overtraining. And if you are like riding that overtraining line, if you are working out every day really intensely, it is much more important to be keeping track of your recovered state. So I'll include a link to Amazon for this thing. You can find them in medical supply shops, things along those lines. Again, if you're new to the channel, day one is in the link. Go check that out. If you need a kettlebell, I've included a link to Kettlebell Kings. If you would like to join my mailing list, the link is down there in the description below. Links to the gym, crossfitportland.com, blueoxgym.com for Blue Ox Athletics. It's the same gym, just different websites. And then my website, strengthanddiscipline.com. Those are all things that are down in the description below. Thanks for following along. And if you like it, subscribe. If you don't like it, don't subscribe. And or thumbs up on the video. Cool. Thanks.